Hey everybody and welcome back. Today we're coming at you with a very exciting video. It's the one that you've been waiting for a very long time. You all guys have been asking for it and finally the day is here. Today we are reintroducing to you the better, the new, the improved books for English and Hindi. You can see on your screen the new cover pages for our English and Hindi books, and it says ASAP Edu's Hindi Translation Master Hindi English Word List, and also ASAP Edu's English Vocab, the Master Word List for all competitive exams. And the GK book, as you can see on your screen, is coming very soon. Before we go any further, we just need to address this. The option was to wait for the GK book and release all three of them together, but that could have taken a long time. And since so many exams are near and since so many of you have been waiting, we decided that we are going to release the English and Hindi books right now so you guys can get to studying, and very soon we will also release the GK book. It's coming, everything is on its way, everything is working. Do not worry, the GK book is coming to you guys, please do not worry. But right now we have the Hindi and English book for you, so you guys can start preparing at least for those two, which make a whole lot of marks. It has a whole lot of weightage. It is the thing that can distinguish you from all the other aspirants. So now that we have addressed about the GK book, let's get into the exciting part. And before we show you more about the books and what all is in there, what all is improved, what is new, let me just go ahead and say that the English and Hindi books are now available on Amazon India, and you can go ahead and you can buy them right now. Let's discuss more of what all has changed and what all has improved. So the hashtag for our books is nothing like this ever, and as you will see in the course of this video, these books are completely new and there is nothing in the market that can even come close to this. As you can see on your screen, it says ASAP Edu's English Vocab. And the reason we've made it ASAP Edu is because the English Vocab books are so good and you guys love it so much that so many people have utilized the books who are not even preparing for judiciary, and we get these amazing emails where people tell us that we were just not good in English, we did not know a lot of English, and we used your books, we did 10 pages a day as you recommended, and our English has improved a lot, we can talk better in English. We've gotten emails where people have used it for a lot of other exams which we did not even know about. So based on your reviews and feedback, we have now made it in such a way that it can be used for any exam. We have utilized our groundbreaking batching technique again, which we batch up the words which have a similar theme. We have given the meaning of the words, we have given the etymology of the words, we have given synonyms, we have given antonyms, we have given pronunciation, we have given example sentences, so you never have to wonder how to use it in a sentence. So we have given all of those things. As you can see on your screen, the foreword by Rahul sir from Rahul's IAS. We are so blessed to have had Rahul sir given this foreword, and we are very grateful for it. As you can see, it's in the beginning of the book, and then we see how you can use the book, an illustration, how to study this book. Let's see the table of contents. So in the table of contents, you can see that there are word meanings in which so many words have been patched up that there cannot literally be a word for any exam or for learning English that can be outside of this book. You will be good to go for English when you see the words. We have also given the word roots, commonly used words from other languages, for example from French, from Italian, from German. We've given idioms. Again, all the idioms have been batched up by theme, you will see, and it is mind-blowing. And then you can see that there's legal maxims and Latin phrases too. So let me show you quickly what the word meanings look like. So the word meanings, as you can see on the very first page, these are all the kinds of governments. Democracy, which is a government run by the people. Oligarchy, a government run by a few powerful and dominant people. Then there is autocracy, a government run by people with unlimited powers. So all of the different kinds of governments we've patched up. This is the quick one or two pages in which the simpler words, which all sound the similar, which all sound similar and are very confusing, we've quickly patched them up so you can get it out of the way, and then we get into the deep diving. So now we see all the words and all the pronunciation and the etymology and sentences and all of it. So let's take an example book, you guys. You can see there's so many words and all of them have been patched up, all of them have synonyms, all of them have antonyms, if there are any, if there is any homonym. So homonym is a word which sounds similar. I'll show you an example when it comes up. So let's take one batch of words and just see as an example what does it mean to batch up words. So on your screen you can see assuage, which the meaning is to calm down intense feelings. The manager tried to assuage the anger of customers after a rat was found in the kitchen. The synonym for it is to allay. For example, how do you use it in a sentence? The sentence is, the party president tried to allay the fears of the allies before the elections. Now, this batch of words, this box that you see, has all words which are either similar sounding or have similar meanings. So, assuage has been batched with placate, which also means to calm a person down. And then you can see in front of placate, there are also synonyms. To mollify, to pacify, to conciliate. So all of these words which mean the same, you finished in one batch. You know that all these words mean the same. So if someone says, hi, I tried to placate his anger, or I tried to mollify this person, you will know that all of them mean the same thing. It's not anything different. So we've also given the noun form, which is placation, pacification, mollification. And if there's an antonym, we've given that too. So antonym is to provoke, to enrage. If placate is to calm someone down, then the antonym and the opposite of it is to provoke or to enrage someone. And then the batch includes reconcile, appease. All of these words mean the same thing, is to calm down, but in different ways. For example, reconcile is to restore friendly relation between two fighting parties, but it almost is the same thing. So all this batch of words, when you do together, you have to use lesser brain power. So later on, when you remember the batch, you'd be assuage, placate, mollify, reconcile, appease. Oh yeah, all of these things mean to calm someone down or to make someone happy. So you can see that all these words are patched up. Let's take an example here again. See, elicit, elicit, proscribe, injunction, writ, impinge, infringe, perpetrate, all of these legal words which are similar. So if there is a theme, if they're all legal words, if they're all medical words, if they're all tailoring words, if they're all food related words, we have batched up by theme, by homonym, by how they sound, by what they mean. So if there is anything which can confuse you ever, we have made it very simple by batching them up. For example, you can see here, so many medical words have been batched up. And there's so many words, for example, which can be used to describe the appearance of either a person or an object. Musculature, rotund, cherubic, girth, stout, thickset, all of these are together. So you know all the descriptive words together. The entire book, you guys, is patched up and you will never get confused between words. So I was telling you about homonyms. Look at this here. It says evacuate, emulate, exude, extrude, protrude, obtrude, intrude. So these are all similar sounding words and people get confused. So when you do these together, you will be able to compare and contrast and understand the difference between these similar sounding words. For example, extrude is to expel, to get something out. And the synonyms would be to shunt out, to oust, to eject. For example, ejecting a tape from a VCR. And trude, which sounds so much similar, is to force something on someone. He always obtruded his thoughts on others. So extrude and obtrude, which both sound so similar, but you know the difference now. Extrude is to eject, get it out, and obtrude is to force on someone. So you will never get confused between this batch of words. So all the words have been batched up, and then you can see that we've used words from other languages. We've given any commonly used words from other languages. For example, the French words on the very first page on your screen, you can see Monsieur, Mademoiselle, oui, enchanté. Any of the commonly used French words, maybe half a page. So there are words from German words which have become popular, some Spanish words that you should know, etc. And then you can see all the idioms also are patched up by theme. For example, on your screen you see to marry above oneself, to go in the family way, patter of tiny feet, second childhood, latchkey kid. And all of these are regarding either marriage or children. And then underneath of that you can see teething troubles, growing pains. They sound similar, teething troubles, growing pain, and they also mean something similar. And again, the etymology is given, which makes it so much easier to understand the idiom. For example, see, growing pains is the short-term problem encountered by an organization when they start to become big. So initially, whenever an organization starts becoming big, they have some small problems. These can be called teething troubles, these can be called growing pains. And the etymology is that this refers to the pains in the limbs and joints of children during growth spurts. So when children grow and their bones grow and their joints grow, they have these pains because it's a difficult process. And similarly, from that etymology, people use this very often when talking about companies or organizations, that this company is having growing pains. So once you understand where the etymology is from, what is the source, what is the story behind this idiom, it is so much easier to understand. We have given the etymology for all the idioms, wherever it's a good story, wherever you need to know the background of it, where you can understand the idiom better because of the story, we have given the etymology so you can understand it so much better. And all the idioms have been patched up by theme, they have been patched up by meaning, they have been patched up if they sound similar. So you will never forget an idiom, you will never get confused between two similarly sounding idioms, and you will remember them so much better from all the stories that are there in the idioms. And then the similarly, we've also patched up legal maxims, we've patched up the Latin phrases, everything is patched up. So that's the English book for you. And then let's also see the Hindi book quickly. Again, the preface is there, and then there is the foreword by Rahul sir from Rahul's IAS, which we are so grateful for. And here's the table of contents for the Hindi book. You can see on your screen there is a list of word meanings. Then there is the English translation of some common laws and rules. So any laws and rules which there are phrases, not just words, that you need to know, we have translated for you. And then there's English translation of important parts of the Constitution of India. And there's English translation of important legal words. So if you want to learn translation from Hindi to English, this is the book for you. And if you want to learn the translation from English to Hindi, again, this is the book for you. If you have very good English and you don't know how to translate in Hindi, for example, in Delhi Judicial Services, they ask translate in Hindi and they give you a difficult passage and you don't know Hindi very well, you will learn everything, constitution, legal words, any important other words that are required. But on the other hand, you are very good in Hindi. Aapki Hindi bahut achhi hai, but aapko English nahi aati. And aap practice karna chahte ho English translation. This is the book for you because it will show you Hindi and English words side by side. So this works both ways, English to Hindi and Hindi to English. So here's the first batch of words. Again, all the words have been batched up, so they are very easy to remember. You can see on your screen Swatantrata, Azadi, Mukti, Swadhinta. And what do they mean? They mean freedom, independence, liberation and emancipation. And then underneath of it is a full batch of words, which is Swatantra, Azad, Mukt, which means, and again, all the words can be used for Swatantra, Azad, Mukt. Free, independent, liberated, emancipated, all of these words can be used. Swatantra Ichha, free will. Swatantrata Divas, freedom day or independence day. Swatantra or Nishpaksh Chunav, free and impartial elections. So everything that is Swatantra related, freedom related, independence related, everything is patched up over here. Similarly, you can see on your screen all of the words regarding dharm are patched up. So different kinds of religions. Dharm is religion, then there is dharmic, dharmanishtha, dharmikta, pavitra, pavan. So Hindu, Musalman, Isai, Sikh, inko kya kehte hain? Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, as you can see on your screen. So it goes Hindi to English and English to Hindi. If you're good in Hindi and you want to learn English and you want to learn how to translate, you must use this book, because for every Hindi word that you can think of, there is an English word which is given in this book. And if you're very good in English but you don't know Hindi, again, this will be very helpful for you. The English book is there to get your English ready, like lay down the foundation. It will give you words, it will give you idioms, you can use it in exams, you can learn English well. But in addition to that, if you want to further augment this English and you want to learn the translation, English you've learned the words, but you also want to learn translation of how to translate the thoughts in your head into a different language. If your thoughts are in Hindi, how do you translate in English? If your thoughts are in English, how do you translate in Hindi? For that, this is the book. So both of these books are complementary to each other and they are must to become proficient in both Hindi and English and translation and doing well in exams and life. So on your screen you can also see that all of the laws which are there, we have given you the English and Hindi translation for it. So what and we've also given you the English translation of important parts of the Constitution of India. So if you're preparing for an exam, and sometimes people buy Diglot and then they study the entire Constitution from it and then the Hindi or the English translation of it, you don't need to buy Diglot separately. Everything is over here. All the important parts of Constitution are here translated Hindi to English, English to Hindi for you. So if there is actually a translation passage in any of the exams from Constitution, all the important words, all the important phrases, all the important parts of the Constitution are here, which have been translated. And then some of the important legal words, which are very commonly used, which you should know, we've also given that. For example, on your screen, you can see Kanun ka saman sangrakshan. It is equal protection of laws. Afsaro ki samanta is equality of opportunity. So these are common phrases which are used, common legal words which are used. For example, equal protection of laws, equality of opportunity. All of these things you need to know, and so that you don't have to go ahead and hunt and make these phrases yourself, we've given them very nicely, very conveniently patched up for you, so you can go through these. And the most important part, the additional part which we've done in this book, is that we have given past year translations. We've done the translations for you, so you can actually see how to translate, you can practice it, and you can see past year papers too. So this is the UPSC, Union Public Service Commission, mains exam paper which we've translated. We've also done translations for Delhi Judicial Services, for Haryana Judicial Services. Again, even if it is not that you're not, even if it is that you're not appearing for an exam, let's just assume that for a second. Then also, just to see the translations on right hand and left hand, and just to see the full paragraph, it creates new connections in your brain. You see it from a very new perspective. Yes, you know all the words, but how do you see them in sentences? How do you see them in paragraphs? How do you see the entire idea translated from one language to another? So we've given full paragraphs. In addition to this, there is, when you buy the book and you read it, you will find something interesting. There is also some bonus material which you can get access to, and how to get it is also given in the book. It's exciting, it's fun, you're going to love it. So these are the English and Hindi books which are complementary to each other, and they are must for getting proficient in English and Hindi both. So these books are now available on Amazon in India. Guys, do not wait, do not walk, run, get them. And the GK book is also coming very soon. We look forward to hearing your feedback on these new and improved books. We hope you like them. We worked very hard for them. So please share with us, how do you feel about it? How do you like it?